We have the great pleasure to have head coach Matt Bechtel with us. Coach, thanks for taking the time to join us. We've had a long following of you from South Hills, Chino Hills, and now here to Damien High School. A lot of folks say, you've come back home. Give me your thoughts. Does it feel like you're back home? And what's the transition been like?
Well, yeah, I mean, first and foremost, it is a homecoming, 100%. There's just something different when you go to a school as a student, and you credit a lot of what you've learned, not just as a football person, but as just a human being, you know, to the mentors you had. And so I felt like at some point in my career, I wanted to come back. I wanted to pour back into others what was poured into me. And so I'm getting goosebumps right now as we're talking, and I love being back. It's a phenomenal school, phenomenal opportunity, and I'm just blessed to be able to do it.
Now, when we talk Matt Bechtel football and the programs you've had in the past, every time you get involved in it, that program flourishes. You're back home, you're back to Damien. What is your ultimate goal to do with this program and paint that masterpiece?
Well, first and foremost, and I've said this before in different interviews, the number one thing is the non-football stuff. And I talk about the way you carry yourself as a person. And we talk about a championship culture, but that doesn't mean winning a league title or winning a CF title. It's the way you go about your business on a day-to-day basis. The way you attack your studies, the way you attack the weight room, the way you attack life in general. And I tell our guys all the time, you can't be a championship team until you're a championship individual. And so changing the attitude, the culture. And then the second component is getting the young men to understand attention to detail. How you do anything is how you do everything. And so that kind of fits in with that championship mindset. And then lastly, we want to be tough. We want our kids to be physical. And so we push the weight room very, very hard in the off season. And we hope that that combination is going to allow us to turn this program around.
Now, what would you say is the key common component when you come into a program that you bring with you? Could be whether it's your philosophy, your coaching staff. What would you say that is?
Well, I think to put it very simple is the attitude, the championship mentality that, like I said a few minutes ago, that you attack everything in your life with. But more importantly than that, I'm a big believer that it's not about X's and O's. It's not about the offense or the defense we run. But it's about forming a connection with the young men so that they understand that you care about them as people first, human beings first. And when you get young men to understand that and they know you care about them, win or lose, you don't base their value on the success of your win-loss record, but you base it on the fact that they're human beings. They're somebody's son. They're going to be somebody's dad and somebody's husband down the road. And so that's our number one job this year, is we're trying to connect with the kids. And we know as that gets better, our kids are going to run through a wall for us.
Now let's talk about your team. We had a chance to see you at week zero, tough Glendora game, and it just seems like that schedule just keeps getting tougher and tougher. Tell me a little bit about your staff that we're going to see on the field in 2019.
Well, I mean, the biggest thing is I feel we're getting better. I feel as the players get acclimated to the nuances of our system, I feel like they're showing improvement each week. Glendora is a very good team. Claremont, I thought Claremont was pretty decent, you know, and all things considered. Obviously, St. Francis got some very good football players, and so too now does Charter Oak. And so I like playing tough non-league games. I love playing a tough preseason because for us, it gives us a good measuring stick of where we're at. And so I feel like you're going to see a lot of what we did against Glendora tonight. Charter Oak runs similar defense, similar offense, and so the game plans are going to be similar. My expectation is that we're going to be able to execute our game plan better tonight.
Finally, what do you see yourself setting as the goals for this year for this team?
Well, to be honest with you, I haven't set a win-loss record goal. I mean, obviously, we hope to win more than we lose. But my biggest thing is getting these guys to buy into the four pillars of what our program stands for, and that's trust, right? Trust in each other, trust in the system, commitment. No matter what happens in the game, we're committed to each other. We're committed to the process. Courage is number three. You got to play this game with courage. And then lastly, which I think is the biggest component about Damien, is brotherhood. You know, when you're in an all-boys school, there's just a different connection you have with your teammates and your classmates. And so I'm hoping if at the end of the year, no matter what our record is, if we can figure out those four things, I think it sets the table for what we want to build in the future.
All right. Head coach Matt Bechtel, the Damien Spartans. Coach, as always a pleasure to have a chance to talk with you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Appreciate
so much.
You. Yep. Take care.